Hi, I'm Vital from Creativity Prompt, and I'm so excited to show you my first clear stamp set. It's called Everyday Hexagons, and as the name indicates, it has 8 hexagons, both outline design and negative design. I show you up close the negative hexagon design. You'll see it better when I actually stamp with it. And it also has 3 text stamps: today, this day, and every day. It's great to use with the banner and labor stamp, but you can also use it with any other stamp. Just use a light ink on the image stamp and a darker ink with the journaling stamp, or you can also emboss the text stamp to make it pop. And this entire set is perfect for scrapbooking, project life type paper crafts, or smash books, but it's also great for card makers to use as embellishments on cards and as individual accents. It's great for backgrounds, or also to stamp and cut. The shape is very easy to cut and put on pop dots. And now let's see it in action. I start with the negative hexagon stamp. I make sure it's well inked, and here I just look that it's saturated. Apply some pressure and also wait a few seconds for the ink to get absorbed better into the cardstock. And now this is the outline banner stamp. I really like to use that to spell the word thanks, because you have the exact amount of banner shapes to spell thanks, so I think it's nice. And here I have a very graphic hexagon design, great for backgrounds or to add accents. And I'm trying to align it. In a very awkward position because I'm standing behind the camera and trying to reach from the side to the cardstock. So I'm not doing the best job at stamping, which you can see here. I shifted when I took off the stamp, so I'm trying again. And I will also stamp this banner negative stamp the third time to show you that you can both stamp it upright or upside down, depending on whether you want the banner to face to the left or to the right. And the same things goes with the label stamp. You can stamp it like that when the label faces the right side, or starts from the right side. It actually faces or points to the left. And here it is stamped upside down, and now I'm using the outline hexagon stamp, which goes perfectly with the negative hexagon stamp to create interesting backgrounds. And here is a negative banner stamp, which is also great for greetings or just as an accent. I also like to stamp other greetings inside, or use letter stickers to spell the greetings. And this is the last of the hexagon stamps, and it has a graph paper design. So it's great as a visual aid, but it's also great for journaling. Here I show you how I stack several impressions of the stamp to make an interesting journaling spot on a layout. Sorry, and you can extend the place you have for journaling by just butting the stamped image together. And now I show you the text stamps. And the first one is every day, and it has a distressed look to it. And the second one says this day, and it's bold, very simple, classic font. And the last one says today, and it's an outline stamp, so you can stamp as is or color inside. And I'm sure you can find lots of more creative ways to use it, and here are all the stamped images. I'm sorry for messing up. This is a glimpse of the first time I used the stamp right out of the package. I just was so excited that I took an ink pad and just stamped all the stamps one after another. Here you can see the text inside the designated place. Here I show you how very easy it is to align the stamps together to create very, very fast background. So you don't need to calculate anything or to try and make them align. You just butt them one next to each other without leaving any space on your acrylic block, and it doesn't have to be a stamp press, just a big enough acrylic block for your background. And then you can stamp them all together, and after I release the stamp press, you can see that they are just perfectly aligned, just the right space between them. It is great for quick backgrounds. And here I show you, as I said before, that you can extend your journaling space by stamping the stamps together. And now I show you how I use the individual banners to spell the greeting, which I think is fun. Here you can have an up-close look at that. And now let's make a card. I start with a standard size card, which is 4 1/4 wide and 5 1/2 inch tall. And opened, it's 8 1/2 inch wide and 5 1/2 inch tall, then scored at 4 1/4. And together with that, I'm using a panel from the exact same cardstock. I'm just using the extra I have after I cut it to 5 1/2. And this is 3 3/4 wide and 5 inch tall, which is exactly 1/2 inch narrower and shorter than the card base. And this is the area where I will stamp my images. I'm going to use the negative background stamp, and because I'm using a negative stamp, I am going to try and eliminate the static on the panel as best I can. With an old dryer sheet. I actually bought the new powder tool, but my order hasn't arrived yet, so I cannot tell you if it works better or not, but I'm just using what I have at hand. And then I'm going to use a Versamark ink, which is a clear and sticky ink. You can see that my ink pad is very dirty, but it doesn't matter. And I'm starting at kind of halfway lengthwise and close to the left edge. And then I try to align it as best I can, up and down. And I will also add some underneath the first one. underneath and to the right. Here you can see me trying to align it as best I can. As I said, I'm at a very awkward position because of the camera. And then I will also stamp a couple more time on the right side to create a bit more balance. And then after that, I will disperse the embossing powder. I'm using clear embossing powder to keep the monochromatic look. And then I will melt the embossing powder with my heat tool. Here you can see me apply the embossing powder, and I'm trying to get rid of all the excess, but there was still some static left, so I cleaned it with my fingernails. Thanks God for fingernails, right? And next I'm going to heat set it, or actually emboss and melt the embossing powder. When I'm using my heat tool, you can see that I'm trying not to point it at one place for too long. So I'm moving it around, and I'm trying to hit the back side too to kind of eliminate the warping of the page, although it will get a bit warped. And then I will add a foam adhesive to this panel and adhere it at the center of the card base. I'm going to try out different types of foam adhesive. Usually I like the thinner ones, and I'm very paranoid with foam adhesive because it's very disheartening when you invest time and effort to make a handmade card, and then when the recipient gets it, it starts to disintegrate. The foam dots fall down, or the panel sags inward, and I'm trying to eliminate that, so I'm probably putting more foam dots than needed, but better safe than sorry. I've already had the bad experience of sending a card through the mail and then finding one of the die-cut words that was supposed to be adhered with some foam adhesive on my carpet, which means it didn't make its way to the recipient. So I'm putting more than needed, and here I adhered the card panel to the card base. Now I'm taking some American Craft stickers. They're made of raw chipboard. I'm not sure if this specific set is available right now, but any set will do, because as you can see, the color wasn't quite right to match with the craft cardstock. So I missed it with October afternoon hitching post mist from the Sarsaparilla collection. You can use any craft colored mist or ink pad. You can just directly ink it with an ink pad. All I wanted to do was to change the color of the letter thickers to match the craft cardstock. Now I let it dry and I clean the mess up, and I'm adhering the thickers with some liquid adhesive. I know that they are adhesive backed, but as I said before, I better be safe than sorry, so I add some liquid glue to each individual letter and adhere it on a white background. I use a white background to make the greeting pop over the otherwise monochromatic card, and it really helps to make the greeting stand out, although it's white, it's not really colored. And then after tearing it, because the font is very thick, I'm cutting with scissors very close to the letter themselves. And then I will adhere it with some more foam dots to the card, and I'm aligning it with the left side of the card itself rather than the panel to add additional visual interest. And now to finish it off, I add some bling with a basic gray's old packaging of Bling It, I think it's called. And I'm just using some scissors to cut the individual gems and trying to adhere the gems in as random pattern as I can. Some of my face wants to make an appearance too. Guess my nose envies my hands or something, I don't know. And this is it. That's the card. Very clean and simple. Monochromatic, except for the a pop of white in the greeting. And I hope you've enjoyed it. And I want to thank you so much for watching and for going along with me as I demonstrate my new everyday hexagons stamp set. These stamps are available exclusively at creativityprompt.com/shop. You can find the link at the down bar. And thank you so much. Bye bye.